This butchery demonstration video has been developed by AHDB Beef and Lamb as part of their meat education program, an accessible and free to use educational resource. Full details of the program can be viewed at the end of the video.
The thick flank consists of many different muscles with different eating qualities. To start off, we remove all the gristle from the outside of the thick flank. Once this gristle is removed, I can now follow the natural seam on the top of the thick flank to remove this thin muscle. I continue to follow the seam and also remove the thin muscle which is situated next to the femur, which is the largest leg bone. Now the two muscles are removed, I'm going to separate them by following this sinew. And we'll land up, as you can see, with two individual muscles. This muscle, which was situated next to the femur, is the most less tender muscle out of the thick flank. We remove all excess fat and connective tissue. And this muscle can now be used for bracing steak by butterflying the smaller part into a bracing steak. Alternatively, instead of steaks, we could use this muscle for diced bracing. The small muscle from the top of the thick flank is a very tender muscle. It's a very fine grain. However, one part of the muscle, as you can see, has a coarser grain than the other. So we remove the coarse part of the muscle, which can be used for diced bracing steak or bracing steak. However, the tender part can be used for parfaits. Now we're left with the remaining two muscles, which can be separated by following this thick center gristle. Now the two muscles are separated. I'm going to start with the center muscle, which is often referred to as the bullet, and we remove all gristle. Once that is removed, you can also see that there is a thick gristle running through the center of this muscle, and by carefully scraping the gristle, we can separate the two parts of this muscle. The gristle runs almost to the end of this muscle. And is now removed. And as you can see, this leaves us with a muscle with a very fine, tender grain. However, this part of the muscle is very tough. That is because it is situated and attached to the kneecap. The other part is a very tender muscle. So this part, after being removed, can be used for bracing steak or diced meat. Then we separate this muscle in two parts and cut them into individual center cut steaks. And as you can see, it's a very fine grain with intermuscular fat. Alternatively, this muscle can also be used as a mini joint by placing on little roasting bands. That will be then the center cut mini joint. Now I'm left with the largest muscle out of the thick flank, which contains also a lot of gristle, which need to be removed. As you can see, one part of the muscle has a very fine grain, while the other part of the muscle is very coarse. We separate the coarse grained muscle, and this part can also be used for bracing steak or diced bracing, because it needs longer cooking. This part of the muscle, which has a very fine grain, can be cut into thin escallops, which are suitable for frying and grilling. However, we recommend that using the thick flank in this method needs to be matured for a minimum of 14 days.
AHDB Beef and Lamb has launched the Meat Education Program, an accessible and free-to-use web-based educational resource for the whole of the meat industry. It aims to help you to enhance both your knowledge and understanding and provide you with certification. It is targeted at the whole of the meat supply chain, including learn how to debone and break down beef and lamb carcasses into primal cuts, and how to cut primal muscles into retail and food service cuts. Learn how to produce cuts that deliver a more tender and consistent eating quality. Learn how to recognize different beef and lamb cuts and understand the best cooking methods for each. Learn about new cuts and how to identify opportunities for these products on menus. Learn about cattle and sheep production, what the different breeds are used for, and the names used to describe different types of animals. Learn about carcass classification and the factors that can affect meat quality. Understand the difference between service and hospitality and learn how to read your customers. Learn about the different meat cuts, specifications, and what they're used for. Learn about the meat industry in general, the various stages of the supply chain, and understand the different terminology used. Learn about different cuts of meat, where they come from, and their use in the different industry sectors. At the heart of the Meat Education Program is an innovative web-based platform which can be accessed via AHDB Beef and Lamb's trade website. Online assessment and certification are available free of charge for the theory modules. The three practical beef and lamb modules will be assessed at the learner's place of work by highly experienced butchery professionals. There are 16 theory and practical modules in the Meat Education Program, and each is supported by must-read study materials, free to download, that have been produced to help learners achieve optimum results. You can track your own progress online while you are logged in. The website will highlight which assessments have been taken, results, and any certificates that have been achieved. To register to start using the Meat Education Program, or for further information, visit www.qsmbeefandlamb.co.uk/MEP.